Kanye West and Drake delighted fans in Los Angeles when the duo took to the stage in their December benefit concert. Titled Free Larry Hoover, the concert seemingly ended a long-time feud between the rappers, as both performed hit songs from their respective catalogs at the Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum. "I'm making this video to address the ongoing back and forth between myself and Drake," West said in a Twitter video posted by music executive Jay Prince prior to announcing the benefit concert. "Both me and Drake have taken shots at each other, and it's time to put it to rest." The duo teamed up and live-streamed the momentous show on Amazon for fans all around the world to enjoy. "We're extremely proud to be working with Kanye and Drake on this historic concert in support of a cause they are both so passionate about, and to collaborate across Amazon for this epic entertainment event," said Amazon studio head Jennifer Salk per People. The concert took over the internet as fans from both camps made peace in the hip-hop world, and West attempted to make peace in his marriage by changing lyrics to Runaway, a song he released in 2010. "I need you to run right back to me, baby," more specifically Kimberly, West sang at the event, addressing his pending divorce with Kim Kardashian. While West and Drake's performances were the obvious highlight of the night, did the show live up to its charitable aims? Did all of the proceeds from Kanye and Drake's concert go to charity? The Larry Hoover benefit concert featuring Drake and Kanye West was put on by the rappers in an effort to reconcile in front of the world and to raise money for a good cause. Ticket sale profits from the concert went to multiple organizations, including X-Cons for Community and Social Change, Hustle 2.0, and Uptown People's Law Center, according to Pitchfork. The rappers teamed up in an effort to raise awareness of the need for prison and sentencing reform. The show itself was named after Larry Hoover, the co-founder of the Gangsta Disciples, who is serving 6 life sentences in a Colorado prison. While ticket sales from the 70,000-plus seat venue went in Larry Hoover's honor to prison reform organizations, fans were initially upset to learn that merchandise profits were not. On December the 10th, GQ reporter Eileen Carter tweeted, "A rep confirmed none of the proceeds from the Yee, Drake, Denma, Amazon fashion merch for last night's Larry Hoover benefit concert will go to criminal justice orgs," along with a GQ report on the subject. However, by December 14th, Pitchfork reported that the GQ article was erroneous, and GQ retracted their initial report, writing that whilst Amazon had initially stated that merch sales would not be earmarked for charity, West's team later clarified that a portion of the merch proceeds will be donated. Instead of digging into his greatest hits catalog and making this concert feel like a versus battle, Drake chose to perform records released during the pandemic or landing on Certified Lover Boy and test some out on the audience for the very first time. His set was headlined by tracks such as Wants and Needs, Life is Good, What's Next, No Friends in the Industry, and the Kid Cudi assisted IMY2, Way Too Sexy, Laugh Now, Cry Later, and fittingly was finished off with the Diamond Certified God's Plan. "I appreciate Kanye for having me up here tonight," Drake added of the surreal scene that didn't seem possible just months ago. "It's important that we make this happen. When we were walking through the arches right there, it felt like a dream. It felt surreal. It was something I always wanted to do, being on stage with my idol as he's running through one of the best catalogs in music, period." West returned to join Drizzy on stage following an outfit change and helped bring the show across the finish line with Donda standouts like Hurricane and Come to Life. He even threw fans a curveball with Yeezus's Bound, but also brought them back a decade to The Throne with Ends in Paris. As far as predicting what the final record of the night would be, it's highly doubtful anyone had Forever as the song of choice on their bingo cards. But yes, the 2009 track featured in LeBron James's documentary, which originally served as a knighting of sorts with Drake receiving the stamp of approval from Rap's Goliath, closed the lights.